Welcome to Fox Valley Technical College. My name is Katie Frost and I'm an admissions specialist here at the college. The intention of this video is to help guide you through the entire admissions process for our aeronautics pilot training and aeronautics professional pilot programs. We know that there are a lot of steps along the way, so you can use this as a tool and as a resource to guide you through the entire process. Don't worry, we will help you through every little step. Let's get started. You can follow along in one of the program admissions guides, which can be found at the address below here. There's a full program student guide as well as a transfer student guide. The full program guide is for students that don't have any flight training. They do not hold any flight certificates or ratings. Maybe they've started their flight training, but they haven't received a flight rating or a certificate. So what they want to do though is start with their private pilot training right at Fox Valley Tech and work through the process at that point. If you're a transfer student, if you already have a flight certificate or rating, or you have the intentions to transfer one of those in. So the process is very similar throughout both sections and both guides. There's just a couple different steps along the way, so we'll wanna make sure that we get you the right steps. Your next step is gonna be determining what program plan is the best for you. So let's go through our technical diploma and our associate's degree to figure out which plan is the best for your training. We have two different program plans in which a person can pursue. We have a 32-credit technical diploma and a 60-credit associate degree. The technical diploma is embedded into the associate's degree, so if you start off in the technical diploma and decide you want to pursue that associate's degree later on, that is totally okay. So with the technical diploma, you are going to get your private pilot certificate, your instrument flight rating, and your commercial certificate, both airplane multi-engine land and airplane single engine land. If you decide to do the associate's degree, you get those three that were just listed out, as well as your CFI, which is your certified flight instructor, your CFII, which is a certified flight instructor instrument, and your MEI, which is a multi-engine instructor. Plus you have general education courses that you have to fulfill. Students that are completing the technical diploma are going to have approximately 250 flight hours by the time they are done with the program, and students pursuing the associate's degree are going to have anywhere between 250 and 300 flight hours. At Fox Valley Tech, we hold our Part 141 FAA approved certificate, meaning students that go through our associate's degree are able to qualify for the restricted airline transport pilot certificate at 1,250 hours. When submitting your admissions materials to the college, make sure you're turning them in to this address below, right here at our aviation facility. Keep in mind that it is your responsibility to keep your medical certificate up to date every 12 months. We'll get to those details in just a little bit as we get through the phase one admissions process. We will walk through both phase one and phase two of the admissions guide. We will get you through the admissions process. We'll help you through how to get to new student orientation, how to get to the FAA equipment verification. So keep in mind that new student orientation and that FAA equipment verification, those dates are mandatory to attend on campus. So keep in mind that the program operates on a first come, first serve basis here at the college, and that's how we build our roster. So we typically run those new student orientation sessions and those FAA equipment verification days on a monthly basis. So please make sure that you're planning those accordingly. You can keep track of your student account on your MyFVTC account. So you'll get this right as you apply as a student. So make sure you're keeping up to date with that, and make sure that once you are applied to the college, you're corresponding with us through your FVTC email address. If you've been accepted into one of the flight programs at Fox Valley Tech, you've already submitted an application. However, to get admitted, you still have to fulfill some FAA requirements. There are requirements both from the Fox Valley Technical College standpoint and the FAA that we need to ensure that you have in place before you start your flight training. So let's go through the admissions process and get started. Task one is applying to Fox Valley Technical College. If you've already applied, congratulations. Continue on to task two. If you're applying for the first time, don't sweat it. You can apply to either one of the flight programs at the address listed here and submit your information. The $30 application fee will be assessed as a part of your first semester tuition and fees. If you've been an FVTC student in the past, just log into your MyFVTC account with your student ID and add an application. Both the flight programs at Fox Valley Technical College are in high demand, so make sure you begin the process early. You can apply to the program up to 1 year before you start courses. Task two, an aeronautics tour and program overview. We want to make sure that you get to see all the amazing opportunities available to you at FVTC Aviation. During your visit, you'll be able to see our full motion flight simulators, our classrooms, weather and dispatch, our maintenance hangars, the flight fleet aircraft, and meet with our current students and or instructors. After your tour, we will go through the admissions process with you. Follow the steps outlined in your admissions guide to get your tour scheduled, and we will get you on the calendar. Task 3, Declaration and Aeronautics Intent Form. This can be found in your admissions packet. You will want to make sure that you read, sign, and date this form accordingly to your training endeavors. If you plan to complete the technical diploma, you would indicate that you're going to start with the Aeronautics Professional Pilot Program. If you plan to complete the Aeronautics Pilot Training Associate's degree, you will want to mark that accordingly on your sheet. For our transfer students, if you already hold a flight certificate or plan to transfer a flight certificate into Fox Valley Tech, you will want to make sure that you are filling out the correct form on the admissions guide for transfer students. Please indicate which flight certificate ratings you plan to hold or currently hold within this document. Next, please confirm that you are a U.S. citizen and indicate if you are a military veteran in the boxes below. Sign, date, and bring this form with you to the new student orientation. Transcripts. Submit an official high school transcript, an in-progress transcript if you are still in high school, or an official copy of your GED HSED scores. If you have graduated high school within the last 10 years and had a high school GPA of a 2.75 or higher, the skills assessment requirement below will be met. If you have college transcripts, we would be happy to review those for you. We can determine if you'd have any classes transfer into Fox Valley Tech. Please follow the steps outlined in the admissions guide to get that process started. Task 5, skills assessment. This is only needed for the associate degree plan students. If you start with a technical diploma and decide to pursue the associate's degree later on, you will need to complete this step prior to being admitted to that program. You can see the accepted scores and or transcripts that will meet program requirements listed out on the program admissions guide. Students testing ACCUPLACER, you can test up to 2 times within a 3-year window. If scores do not meet program requirements, you must enroll into program prep courses prior to starting flight classes. If you have an associate's degree or higher, we can waive this by seeing your official transcripts. Task 6, first or second class FAA medical certificate. Everyone is required to hold a first or second class FAA medical certificate. A third class medical certificate is not acceptable. Contact an aviation medical examiner, otherwise known as an AME, to schedule your first or second class medical. Use the address below to locate the nearest one to you. After your medical is scheduled, please follow specific instructions per the AME. Students must keep their first or second class medical up to date every 12 months at Fox Valley Tech. Once you receive your medical certificate, please bring that original document with you to new student orientation. Any questions that you might have in regards to health conditions or medications, please address those with your aviation medical examiner. Task 7, verification of citizenship. We can accept one of the three: your birth certificate and current driver's license, certificate of naturalization and current driver's license, or a current U.S. passport. Please note that all documents must be current and not expired. All of the documents must be the original. No photocopies are accepted. Please bring all these documents with you to the new student orientation. Task 8, submit an application for a student pilot certificate. Follow the steps that are outlined in your program admissions guide. Once you finish filling in your information, you will need to schedule a time to complete your application with one of the following: a certificated flight instructor, an FAA designated pilot examiner, or an FAA inspector. Once this representative fills in their credentials, your application will then be submitted for review. Please keep in mind that this process will take a minimum of 4 weeks for the TSA to complete required background checks, which may take longer for you to receive your student pilot certificate. Please be sure to plan ahead and start this step early. You will need to have a current valid U.S. passport or a real ID indicated with a star in the upper right hand corner to do this step. The flight staff at Fox Valley Tech can assist you with this process. Please follow your program admissions guide as to how to schedule. Print off your completed student pilot certificate application or bring in your temporary airman certificate with you to the new student orientation. If you already have a student pilot certificate or hold a current pilot certificate, please bring that with you to the new student orientation. Task 9, start assessing your finances. Make sure you're applying for financial aid if necessary and making any arrangements you need to be able to have your payment available prior to the first day of flight classes. Task 10, request to attend a new student orientation. Please follow the directions in your program admissions guide so we can invite you to our next new student orientation session. Task 11, attend a new student orientation. Make sure you bring all of your original documents with you to the new student orientation where a representative at the SJ Spanbauer Center will make copies for you. To review, you should bring the following items with you. High school transcripts, if not already submitted. Skills assessment scores, if not already submitted. First or second class FAA medical certificate. Citizenship. Student pilot certificate application, temporary airman certificate, student pilot certificate, or current pilot certificate. Please note that if you fail to bring any of these original documents, you will not be able to participate in the new student orientation session. All right, phase one is complete. You're almost there. There's only a few more steps left in the process. Let's keep going through those. Let's start off with tasks 1 and 2, the program readiness 1 and 2 courses. Students do not have to worry about paying for these courses, but they need to complete them successfully and earn a 100%. Don't worry, the instructors outlined in your packet are there to help you if you have any questions. Please note that unless requested, students will be enrolled into these directly after the new student orientation session. Task 3, purchase all items from the required resource list. You will receive this list when you are on campus for your tour during the Aeronautics Pilot Tour and Overview session. Task 4, once you have all of your items purchased and your program readiness courses are successfully completed, make a request to attend an FAA equipment verification. Please follow the directions outlined in your program admissions guide so we can invite you to the next FAA equipment verification session. Task 5, assemble all of your equipment from the required resource list and bring your temporary airman certificate, student pilot certificate, or current pilot certificate with you. Task 6, again, make sure that you are taking the right steps forward in order to finance the program. If you need assistance or have questions, please visit our Ways to Pay for College page. You can also visit our Student Finance Department, Financial Aid, and Veteran Services. We also encourage that you start looking into scholarships to help fund the program. Congratulations, you have made it through phase 2, all of your admissions requirements are completed, and you will now be admitted into one of the flight programs at Fox Valley Technical College. As you know and learned earlier in this video, we operate on a first-come, first-served basis, and we only have so many seats available in our program every single year. So after your FAA equipment verification, a representative from the SJ Spanbauer Center will notify you to let you know if you have a roster seat or what your next steps are. As a friendly reminder, you will be getting your student pilot certificate in the mail. So once you do receive that card in the mail, make sure you bring it to the SJ Spanbauer Center where a representative can make a copy of that to put that in your file. Keep in mind that we do need this for Part 141 enrollment per the FAA. That's it. We hope that this video was helpful for you as you work towards the admissions process and starting your flight career. So if you ever have any questions, need anything from us, or need to reach out, feel free to reach out to Fox Valley Tech at any time, and we hope to see you a part of the FVTC Aviation family in the very near future. Take care.